بنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله الله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعة فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير السنن سنن محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أما بعد فقال الله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن المجيد يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون وقال سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن المجيد وإذ ابتلى إبراهيم ربه بكلمات فأتمهن قال إني جاعلك للناس إماما قال ومن ذريتي قال لا ينال عهد الظالمين صدق الله العظيم. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, topic of my khutbah today is three great lessons from the life of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, which is sacrifice, hard struggle and leadership. These are the three great lessons we have to learn from the life of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. We are entering into the month of Zilqa'dah, and already we can see a lot of preparations going on for Hajj. Many of our relatives, many of our nearest people are travelling to Hajj from different locations from our own homelands. Also, you can see worldwide people are preparing for the Hajj. So Hajj is a universal occasion, annual occasion for Muslims to learn about the life of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There is a big connection of Muslims with the life of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. And you can see that there are various opportunities are given to Muslims to learn the life of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. There are occasions to learn about the life of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam every day. Also in Quran, Allah Ta'ala mentions about Ibrahim in many occasions and says, for example, in Surah Al-Hajj, Allah Ta'ala says, Millata abikum Ibrahim. You are the community of your father Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, who was a maqamul Muslimin, and he has named you as Muslims. Muslims means one who surrenders to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Min qablu wa fi hadha. In the previous books, during the time of previous prophets as well, and in this book as well, your name is Muslim. All the communities of every prophets, their name were Muslim. Muslim means one who surrenders. Today you can see the name of Ahl Kitab in a different way. For example, Nasara, or Jews and Christians. These are Arabic names, you can say Yahud and Nasara. These are the names not given by the prophets themselves. And they were later on identified themselves with the different names. And because, for example, they identified themselves with Judah, a community of Judah, which is way later than Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. And Christians, for example, Christianity is tagged to Christ. And Christ was not the name of Jesus Christ. It is the translation of Jesus Christ. It is the translation of his name. His original name is Yeheshua or Esu, which is translated in Latin as Jesus. And Messiah is translated as Christ. And from Christ is the Christianity. So these are the names given later on. Originally, every community was given different books. And in these books and their languages, their name was Muslims. Means one who surrenders to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مِنْ قَبْلُ وَفِي هَذَا لِيَكُونَ الرَّسُولُ شَهِيدًا عَلَيْكُمْ وَتَكُونُوا شُهَدَاءَ عَلَى النَّاسِ. And you as a Muslim, your responsibility is to witness unto the mankind. This message is given in Surah Al-Hajj. So we have a great connection with Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. And we have various occasions to remember Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. For example, every day in prayer, we supplicate, Kama barakta ala Ibrahima wa ala ali Ibrahim. When we are sending salutations to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah Ta'ala and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us the method how to send salutation. In that we add Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam and we say, send bounties to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as you have sent bounties to Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam and his family. So we include Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. And particularly in the month of Zilhajjah, which is coming very soon, we have three great occasions where everybody remembers the traditions of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. One is Eid al-Adha, which is the prayer on festival of sacrifice. You can see that large number of people gather in every part of the world. It is an opportunity to rejuvenate your faith. Even in the places where there is no freedom for the practice of Islam, for example, Russia, millions of people gather on the days of Eid to rejuvenate their faith. So this is a global opportunity for every Muslim to rejuvenate their faith and to remember the traditions of Ibrahim alayhi salam. And another occasion is Udhiyya. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, Ma hadhihi al-adhahi sunnata abikum Ibrahim. What is this Udhiyya, or sacrifice? It is the tradition of your father Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Again, this practice is there all over the world. And many million people benefit from this. And again, this is the tradition to remember the traditions of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. And one more great tradition is annual pilgrimage of Hajj, where 2-3 million people gather in Mecca. But the impact and the implication is global. Though people are, the congregation is in Mecca, people are traveling from all over the world. And there are 2-3-4-5 months of preparations. Before the Hajj and after the Hajj, you can see that there is a long period where people affiliate themselves to complete these rituals. So this is a ritual with global impact. Again, this is a great tradition to remember the traditions of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Why this much traditions are given, this much opportunities are given for Muslims to remember the traditions of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, to learn three important lessons. One is sacrifice, another one is hard struggle, and the third lesson is leadership. And if you see the life history of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, this is the history of the same thing, that through the history or traditions or life history of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, you can see that three of these things, sacrifice, hard struggle and leadership, are very important lesson, very important message of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. And his sacrifice started when he declared monotheism. He was chosen as a prophet when he was born in Iraq to the family of priests who were indulged in polytheistic practices. When he was chosen as a prophet, he declared the message of monotheism and he said, Inni bari mimma tushrikun. I am free from all kinds of practices of idolatry in which you are indulged in. This was his declaration. This was not a mere tawheed, not the tawheed which normally some people understand, that it has a very trivial implications. It is very confined message. It was a message which had a implication in every aspect of his society. That's why not only his father, the ruler of time was against him. Ruler of the time, why, if he say that God is only one, why should ruler be against him? Because ruler understood that it has a wider implication. Tawheed has wider implication. Tawheed is not only a message that Allah is only one, but when says Allah is only one, then it has wider implication, and the ruler thought that it will challenge my position as well. Because like Fir'aun, he was also telling that Ana Rabbukum al-A'la, I am the biggest deity and I am the biggest Lord. And he was himself considering himself as a Lord. And among the various things which people used to worship, king was also a person who was supposed to be worshipped. And he was thinking that, I am the person who is giving law and rules and regulations. This was challenge for everything. That's why first of all, father said, go out of my home. And the ruler said, just sending him out of home will not solve the problem. This is a big problem that he is declaring that God is only one. And it will have a greater implications in our society. That's why I have to give a punishment which nobody should forget. And nobody should dare to declare this kind of message in future as well. That's why he wanted to give a lesson to everybody. He prepared a big fire. It was a huge fire. And they prepared an instrument to toss Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam into that fire. Because it was impossible for anyone to put him inside that fire. Because it was a very huge fire. So they prepared an instrument and finally they tossed him into the fire. And Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam said, I am prepared. And you can see in the life history of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, though the leadership promise of leadership is given at the end, but whenever there is a do or die situation, Allah's mercy came, Allah's help came. So Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam said, I am prepared for that. And he was tossed into the fire. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said, Ya naru kuni bardan wa salaman ala Ibrahim. O fire, become cool and become safe to Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. So fire became cool and safe, and Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam came out from the fire unhurt. And this was an astonishing incident. And king said, it seems he has a divine mercy on him. So it is better for him, it is better for us to deport him from our country. So he was deported. He said, send him, go out of our country. So he was deported out of the country. Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam continued his mission. He went everywhere, wherever he could go, declaring this message of monotheism. He went to Syria, then he went to Egypt, and finally he ended up in Hijaz. It was thousands of kilometers. You can understand that there was no aeroplanes. He was walking continuously, and finally he reached Hijaz, and by that time he was almost 85 years old. You can imagine the long struggle, continuous struggle. And you know, he was not in any way, he was not in any way frustrated with his continuous struggle. But he was continuously doing efforts, and he became 85 years old. At that time he said, I need a son in order to continue my mission. Is that possible? He supplicated for it. He invoked for it with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, granted him a child, Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam. Then again a test came to him. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said, abandon your child and wife in a barren valley. Wadi ghair zi zar'in. There was nothing in that valley. No fruits, no vegetation, no water. Abandon him. And Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam was prepared for that tribulation and test as well. He abandoned them. But he supplicated, warzuq ahlahu min athamarat. Wallah tabarak wa ta'ala, give them enough sustenance and fruits, etc. and etc. And it is probably the supplication and invocation of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam that we find a lot of fruits, not only even in post-oil era, even in pre-oil era, you can see, if you see the history of Hijaz, there were enough means of sustenance every time. It is probably because of the invocation of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gave him zamzam water and vegetations and fruits and everything. And finally child was growing, and almost he was a teenager. And Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam was very happy that at least my mission is continuing, that I am becoming old, my mission is continuing, I have a great hope in Ibrahim, in Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam. At that time a final test came. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said, sacrifice your son by your own hands for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam, he himself, he said, if it is a test, I am prepared for the test. It was, whole family was prepared for the test. If you see the life of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, it is not only the sacrifice of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, but the whole family was participating in the sacrifice. And finally Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam took his knife and made all preparation for the sacrifice, and even used his knife, and he was about to slaughter his neck of his son. Then finally test is over. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said, test is over. And this is mentioned in Quran. He says, وَإِذِ بُتَلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبُّهُ بِكَلِمَاتٍ فَأَتَمَّهُنَّ. And we have, remember, we have tested Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam by various kinds of tests. فَأَتَمَّهُنَّ, and he completed and he fulfilled all those tests. And it was 100 years. You can see the struggle is almost 100 years. And people usually get frustrated if 2-3 years they do continue a struggle and though they don't see any results, they are frustrated. But this is not the Islamic history. In the whole Islamic history, history is like that. Even the life history of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he lived up to 63 years of his age. And in 63 years, almost up to 61 years, until the conquest of Makkah. You can see in between there are victories like victory of Battle of Badr. But again after Battle of Badr, Battle of Uhud was a challenge, it was a defeat. So there were challenges until till the age of 61. And last 2 years were victorious. You can see the life of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is also like Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa sallam, full of sacrifices and full of struggle. And finally the victory came. And finally the leadership is given. Like Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, also almost 100 years, and the final sacrifice, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala says, قَالَ إِنِّي جَاعِلُكَ لِلنَّاسِ إِمَامًا. Now this is the time we have given you the leadership of the people, global leadership we have given. So Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam asked, قَالَ وَمِن ذُرِّيَّتِي. What about my progeny? There is a difference between zurriya and abna. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam did not ask, how about my children? Qala wa min abna'i. He did not ask this question. Wa min dhurriyati. He asked, dhurriya means, how about my progeny? People are coming, the prophets who are coming after me, and their children, and after that, therefore another prophets coming after me, and their children. How about them? Will this leadership continue with them? This was his question. Usually our Muslims have to have a very broader vision. This is the Abrahamic vision. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam had a greater vision. Even at the age of 100, he was not worried about how about Ismail and Ishaq. He was wondering about how about my next coming generations. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said, Qala la yanalu ahad al-zalimi. My covenant is not with those people who are wrongdoers. This leadership will continue. This leadership given to Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam will continue with your generations. But if your people are among the wrongdoers, if there is zulm in your community, then you will be deprived from the leadership. And this continued. If you see the history of Islam, history of the prophets, leadership continued. Every prophets were given leadership of the various regions, and global leadership was given to so many prophets. Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam was a global leader. Dawood alayhi salatu wasalam was a global leader. Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam was a ruler and a leader. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam himself was given a global leadership. And the leadership continued after that. And during the time of Sayyidina Umar, Muslims conquered Roman Empire and Persian Empire and biggest global leaders. And even the history can see, the biggest empire or the biggest ruling ever people had is the ruling of Umayyad dynasty. Rule up from Sindh in one part to the Spain in other part and in many parts of the Africa, and it was the biggest rule. So that was the biggest rule ever. So Allah Ta'ala has continued this leadership among the people of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, progeny of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, until Prophet and after the Prophet Ibrahim. After the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as well. So here the condition is, here you can see the whole lesson is, you will be given leadership, you will become successful when you do hard struggle and when you make sacrifices And what kind of sacrifices? Every sacrifices. Be prepared for all kind of sacrifices, because when you love something, when you have a commitment towards something, and that commitment should be a priority. Deen should be a priority, religion should be a priority for Muslims. Like Quran says that you have to prepare أَحَبَّ إِلَيْكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ فَتَرَبَّسُوا حَتَّى يَأْتِيَ اللَّهُ بِأَمْرِهِ. Allah Ta'ala mentions the list of things which people love. قُلْ إِنْ كَانَ آبَاؤُكُمْ. Say that your father. وَأَبْنَاؤُكُمْ. And your children. وَإِخْوَانُكُمْ. And your brother. وَأَشِيرَتُكُمْ. And your relatives. قُلْ إِنْ كَانَ آبَاؤُكُمْ وَأَبْنَاؤُكُمْ وَأَزْوَاجُكُمْ. And your spouses and your relatives and your children and your fathers, all these things. وَأَمْوَارٌ اِقْتَرَفْتُمُوهَا. And the money which you earn. وَتِجَارَةٌ تَخْشَوْنَ كَسَادَهَا. And the businesses and your sources of income and your employments, in which you always fear termination or losses in business. وَمَسَاكِنُ تَرْضَوْنَهَا. And your houses, your dwellings, which is a very dearest thing for you. أَحَبَّ إِلَيْكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَجِهَادٍ فِي سَبِيلِهِ فَتَرَبَّصُوا حَتَّى يَأْتِيَ اللَّهُ بِأَمْرِهِ. If all these things, you can see, these are the things which normally dearer to human beings. And Muslims' priority should be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Rasul, and the struggle in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These should be more better priority than all these things. All these things are normal priority of human beings. But for Muslims, priority should be Allah and His Prophet, and the struggle in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then you will be successful. And today, if Muslims are not successful, they should see that where are we making dhulm. Because la yanalu ahdith zalimin, this is not a covenant which continue if you make dhulm, oppression. And what is oppression? There are a lot of definitions about oppression in Quran. For example, Quran says, وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ كَتَمَ شَهَادَةً عِنْدَهُ مِنَ اللَّهِ. Who is the biggest oppressor than one who conceals the testimony given to him? If you are concealing the testimony, because by seeing your life people are not understanding Islam, that means you are concealing the testimony. That means you are making dhulm. One of the dhulm is, if the life of Muslims today is Muslims' role model in everything, telling, conveying the message is not only giving books to people. Conveying message means not only giving lecture to the people. Conveying message means you should produce a role model. Muslims should be role model in everything. By seeing Muslims, people should come to the fold of Islam. For example, in forest countries, in 13th century, business people, traders went to Malaysia and these parts. And today, biggest number, Malaysia and Indonesia. And today, highest number of Muslims are in that region. They saw traders and embraced Islam. So Muslims should be role models. And if you are not role models, you are making dhulm. And there is another explanation of dhulm. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمَ بِمَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. If you are not decreeing according to what Allah has revealed in every aspect of your life, means religion should not be confined to masjid alone. People are Muslims when they are inside the masjid. When they go outside the masjid, they are not Muslims anymore. They are following rules and regulations and injunctions and practices of anything they want. That should not be the case. Every aspect of your life, you should follow the injunctions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and your tawheed should be reflected in every aspect of your life, your transactions, your trades, your dealings with the people and everything. And if you are not doing that, you are making dhulm. So is that dhulm happening with us? Is that oppression happening? And if it is happening, naturally, Muslims are deprived of this leadership. So that's why these are the great lessons. And if you see, Hajj is a great training as well of the similar thing. People, 3-4 million people are trained every year from different parts of the world. And you can see what the important training is, hard struggle. Go to Mina, then to Arafat, then to Muzdalifah, then to Mina again for pelting stones and Tawaf Ifada. And you have to sacrifice your homes. You sacrifice your money, sacrifice your comforts, sacrifice your stay of your homeland. This is the lesson, this is the training given, that you have to learn the lesson of hard struggle, learn the lesson of sacrifices, then you will be given leadership. And this should be the lesson we have to learn. May Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala give us tawfiq to understand the broader lessons of the life of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam and make our ummah a leader of people. Barakallahu lana wa lakum wa nafa'ani wa iyyakum bi ayatihi wa dhikril hakim. Innahu ta'ala jawadun karimun malikun barur raufur rahim wa rahmun halim. Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. As-salatu was-salamu ala rasulihil ameen wa ala alihi wa ashabihi at-tahirin amma ba'd. فقال الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتاب الله العظيم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد